Hey, what's going on, guys? My name is Prestige. Welcome back to the channel. Today, we're going to be dropping a nuke in Infinite Warfare, and I wanted to give you guys some tips on how to get it a little bit easier. The reason I'm making this video is because if you guys didn't know, there are special ops challenges in this game, and I've had a lot of people asking me how to get this specific calling card right here, and it's simply done by dropping a De-Atomizer strike. And the reason I'm making this video is because not all of us have been lucky enough to get a weapon variant that has a nuke attached. With this, you don't need to actually have a weapon variant at all. You'll be able to simply go in, play the game, and get the nuke as long as you can go on a 25 kill streak. And I think that that's really cool. It kind of gives you that feeling of an old school Call of Duty when you don't need to use a specific variant, because let's face it, a lot of the variants out there that are able to get nukes, they're not viable. For example, why would I want to use a pistol to get a nuke? It's just not going to happen in public matches. I'll be melted by an NV4 before I'm able to even pull the trigger. That's just simply how it is. Now for this particular method, we are playing Infected, and guaranteed there are at least 20 or 30 comments down below saying, well, you did it Infected. I don't know why people are getting so butthurt over doing it nukes in Infected. At least you got it, at least you completed the special ops challenge, and you're not restricted to one freaking weapon. You can swap between the Kendall 44 and the Spaz 12, and it's actually a lot of fun to do it this way. So if you happen to get your nuke in Infected and you don't want anybody to know, I would just tell your friends, yeah dude, I dropped this shit in free-for-all, you know, I got 25 kills, didn't die, boom, done. But in reality, I don't think it matters where you drop the nuke. As long as you get the calling card, that's pretty much the end goal of this right here. So for the first tip I would give you, it is when the game first starts, don't spawn in. Wait for just a few seconds until the first infected is chosen and then spawn in. If you do it this way, you'll be guaranteed to never be infected. Now this may actually change in the future. They might actually kick you before that infected timer counts down, but if you want a guaranteed way to never be infected, as of right now, you're able to do it this way. But once you spawn in, it's time for the hunt. Don't do what everyone else is doing. Don't hide in corners. Don't try to find a hiding spot. Try to find the infected. At this point, you want to try to get as many kills on the first 5 infected as you can. And the reason being is because once there starts to become 7, 8, or 9 infected, it becomes increasingly more difficult to fight them all off at once. If there are 5 of them, you can easily escape their grasps. But if there are more than 5, it becomes a little more difficult because the pull of that Spaz 12, it does take a little bit of time. So making sure you have like 9, 10, or even 15 kills before there are over 6 infected, that will actually get you on the way to getting that nuke a lot easier. Because once there are like 6 or 7 infected, it becomes a lot easier for people to get a little bit overwhelmed, taken off guard. There's no way you can fight them all off at once unless you are really good at wall running, finding some really interesting spots to get away, and of course, dodging those throwing knives. So that's what they are in this, by the way, throwing knives. They're not bio spikes. If you get hit by one of them, you're not gonna explode. But the thing is, if there are a lot of them coming at you, you need to make sure that you're constantly moving. So I would recommend just constantly jumping and strafing left and right. If you see them coming your way, try to zigzag a little bit. That way you won't get hit by a knife. And unfortunately, this is the most random way that you're going to die. Sometimes these knives might bounce off of a building and hit you. Sometimes you might be strafing and think that you're in the clear and you might get hit by a knife. It's almost like when they all synchronize their knife throws, it's really, really hard to dodge them. And this is why it's another really important part to try to get as many kills as you can on those first 5 infected. But once again, just try to strafe, try to jump, try to do anything you can to stay out of their way, because a majority of the time when you're on a really high streak, you're gonna die by a random knife, and it sucks. The next tip that I can give you is keep moving. Along with strafing and moving, try to just kind of circle all around the map. Because even though there may be more than 5 infected, you're always going to want to constantly be on the hunt. If you find where they place down a tactical insertion, sometimes it may be beneficial to wait for them to respawn, but if there are multiple enemies within the vicinity, it's not going to be that good for you. So what I would recommend is just constantly moving all around the map. This Genesis map, it's not a very good example because the one thing you don't want to do is get stuck in a corridor. And if you're in that building, it can get really hectic really fast. So I would try to recommend staying out in the open where you can jump and of course where you can use your thrusters to get a little bit higher. But make sure that you are constantly aware of what's going on behind you, because you may not know it, but they could be plotting an attack to come around from behind while you're taking care of what's in front of you. So constantly check your back, check corners, because you never know when an infected is going to be hiding. Now, the final thing that I want to say, do not forget that you have a tactical, which will actually stun the infected and allow you to get easy kills. Now, if you're using a trip mine, and let's say you get a triple kill, those trip mine kills don't actually count towards the De-Atomizer strike. But what I would use them for is more of a warning sequence, if anything. Let's say you are in a tight pinch and you need to place something down. Using that trip mine will allow you to clear up the area, kill off a couple of the infected, and allow you to get the rest of the kills with your shotgun. But the biggest thing and the most important thing about this is that tactical grenade where you can stun your enemies. After every 5 kills with your shotgun and pistol, you'll be able to have another tactical grenade. If there are many enemies running at you at once, let's say there are over 6 of them coming at you, if you throw this down, you can stun them all and kill them all super easy. So this is one of the biggest things that people forget about. I even forget about it from time to time. And if I just remember to throw these things down constantly, I definitely wouldn't have died as much, and I would have more De-Atomizer strikes in this specific mode. But that is pretty much it, guys. This video is all about getting an easy De-Atomizer strike. I didn't want to make a video about it in public matches, one, because I can't do it with the pistol that I have, and two, I honestly think I would just get too frustrated. I often die from behind. It's just something that I'm not really interested in doing, and at least here in Infected, I actually have a fighting chance, along with a lot of you guys that might be watching this video. So if it helped you out, guys, help me out by clicking the like button down below. If you haven't yet, make sure to click the subscribe button for more awesome videos coming each and every day. And remember, guys, if you're currently subscribed to the channel, make sure to hit that notification button to be updated on when I upload every single day. That way you'll get a notification every time I do, so you won't miss a video. Until tomorrow, guys, I'll see ya. Peace.